Greetings, dear listeners. My name is Shirinbai Sarım, and today our broadcast dedicated to William Shakespeare. William Shakespeare was an English playwright, poet, and actor, widely regarded as the greatest writer in the English language and the world's greatest dramatists. He is often called England's national poet and the Bard of Avon, or simply the Bard. William Shakespeare's themes. Introduction. According to Oxford Dictionary of Literary Terms, theme is the silent abstract idea that emerges from a literary work's treatment of its subject matter, or a topic recurring in a number of literary works. Conflict. Conflict emerges as a central theme of Shakespeare's work. If we have a look at Romeo and Juliet, the plot moves around two warring families, Montagues and Capulets. The war of Montagues and Capulets further impacts the families of Verona. Hence, the citizens of Verona are a part of a conflict. Shakespeare opens the play with a prologue, and it is here that he explains the conflict between the Montagues and the Capulets. Two households, both alike in dignity, in fair Verona, where we lay our sin from ancient grudge, break to new mutiny, where civil blood makes civil hands unclean. Shakespeare opens his play with the explanation of old rivalry in the first line. So the conflict is shown as a background and a backdrop of the play in the very first line. Apart from the physical and external conflict, there is also presence of eternal conflict. It is when Juliet comes to know that Romeo is Montague. Her struggle to decide whether to hate or love Romeo gives rise to the inner conflict. At first, she could not believe that she is in love with someone with whom she was supposed to hate. That I must love a loaded enemy. That use of must by Juliet depicts her choice that she has no other choice. She is not in a state to change the fact. Again, there is conflict between Tybalt and Romeo, the conflict between Juliet and her father. All it remarkably presents the theme of conflict in the play. In the same way, Hamlet also suffers with external and inner chaos and conflicts. Externally, he knows Claudius is his enemy, and even Claudius is sure that he cannot trust Hamlet. Claudius desperately tries to win over Hamlet and wants him to accept as his uncle that, but Hamlet is never ready to accept it. And who can forget the substantially discussed and researched internal confusion of Hamlet. his dilemma becomes the focal point of the entire play. As a sensible gentleman, Hamlet's hesitation after ghost revelation and then growing suspicion gives rise to the inner conflict in the play. The most of the tragedies are carrying on the theme of conflict fully. Order, disorder, and change. Most of the plays of William Shakespeare, especially tragedies, carry the idea of pattern of order, disorder, and change. A stable life suddenly gets disturbed and brings about the change. The change can happen to a person, to society, or to the nature as well. For instance, King Lear goes mad. England is divided by civil war, and storms and tempests ruin the life of people and society. Initially, there is stability that gives rise to confusion and then change. Another important thing is absurd, that ending of this place. The ultimate ending of this place is restoration of stability. It has been questioned many times by scholars whether Shakespeare end his place with all restored or the distorted still exist. Rex Gibson, a well-known critic, wrote in his book Teaching Shakespeare, the detailed information about the themes of William Shakespeare. He outlined following examples related to the theme of order, disorder, and change. Nick Bottom is magically transformed into an ass in Midsummer Night's Dream. In Twelfth Night, a false letter tricks Malvolio into changing from a Puritan steward to a foolish would-be lover. Sometimes change happens in unique contexts. The woods, a hit, an island, or a near magical setting of some kind. Time usually underlines the changes witnessed in the place. And now our broadcast is over. Please subscribe to this channel. That was your host, Serik Baevsrum. Goodbye.